Hi, I'm Warwick Dice, and welcome back to Let's Play Shining Force. I now have Balzac by himself, so let's take him out. I got people up a bunch of levels, pretty much. All my knights are promoted at level 2. My mages, except for Henri, are level 2. Domingo is level 7. Ross is 14. And my other character is 15. Let's just cream Balzac. Finish this. If he'd stop murdering! God, I started this battle, and last time I fought him, he evaded, like, non-stop. So, it was rather frustrating to gain, like, a little bit of experience from killing him, or from hitting him. But, Gunst just got, like, a plus 5 attack in his last level, and 15 damage. That's some serious damage. And Arthur has another trick up his sleeve. Which, showing that, I should probably just show it off. Just to show why Arthur's so valuable. But yeah, pretty much he won't attack, so you can pretty much, at your leisure, just keep hitting him. If you have patience, you can sit here, and as long as you're here, he'll regain more hit points back. It's not too bad, but I don't remember him ever regenerating hit points. So, it's kind of confusing. I don't care about waiting an extra turn. Yes, Arthur learns magic. That should be done with one hit point. Yep, he's pretty much the only one that gets that animation. Other than, I think, using healing herbs. But I think healing herbs is still the attack animation. I haven't used this yet. It does wear off rather quickly, though. What's this thing? 9... 20. Ernest is, like, zooming ahead. He actually does more damage than a lot of my other paladins do. Come on. There we go, Arthur. That should be just enough, unless Arthur size attack fails. Nah, and he still wouldn't kill him, so. I want my lead character to get a freaking turn. Ugh. Annoying. I'm gonna be doing this till the cows come home. That's fine. Whatever. Diane, just attack him. You'll probably do like 10 damage or something. Expect that much. Wait. Thank you. Hopefully he hits. And my luck will miss. Yeah, 30 damage. Okay. Yep. I always wondered why they had a fortress so close to Gardiana, if Runefoss is a tiny little nation. Yep. This is where things get a little weird. Go, little ship, go! Music is pretty awesome here, though. So, we get some new monsters. We get Conch. Which I think they have limited on the magic spell. We get Shellfish. I thought one of them had a magic spell. I know they poison. We have some Pegasus Knights for some unexplained reason. And Sea Bats. Lots of Sea Bats. But Sea Bats are pretty easy for me to kill, so it's not a big deal. I do like how the ship's kind of beat up. It's not like some perfect, pristine ship. Frankly, it's a decent car. But that's how most ships are, anyway. You go over here. It's not the sea bats to attack you, because they would do shit to you. And this battle is also why I wanted to keep Diane unpromoted for right now. Is because archers take a huge dip when they get promoted, and their walking speed slows the hell down. They kind of suck, frankly. The only thing that kind of sucks is not having low or other characters with us, unfortunately. Means that we don't have a way to unpoison ourselves other than whatever antidotes we have. But, I mean, I should still have like two or three antidotes on hand if I haven't used them already. God, I love the experience from Sea Bats. Sea Bats! I always think of Sea Bats from Dumb and Dumber. I don't know why. Necessary for some reason in RPGs, especially like pseudo medieval style RPGs. Ah, crap. This guy. She's dead. Ah. She survived. Wow. To always have like these kind of ship battles, it's kind of weird. Never understood it. Like, I understand, like, yeah, people used to get around, but it would suck to get around my ship, especially if you had like heavy armor and stuff on. If that ship fell, you better be ready to take that stuff off quick. Creepy that she's some sort of deer person. by her first form, this looks like rock. I don't know. And it's like so much bigger than her one is. She's like the size of adults. Okay, yes, I've had enough of your sea bounds. Play of Vite, they have spears. I don't know, in a way, I'm kind of annoyed by the experience, how it drops so quickly for your characters, but at the same time, I think it's kind of better off, just because you would probably just stay in, like, the third battle or the fourth battle and just keep doing it over and over until you're, like, 20 promoted and then be done with it. And be like, ah, ha, 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 ha. Alright. I think I should probably kill one of these guys. Like, I want to kill them both, but I know it's an experience, a waste of experience. To kill that other one. Because it has one hit point. Hit point. Kill the stupid Pegasus Knight. Pegasus Knights aren't even worth anything anymore. Bats rest. Like, bats need to have, like, a rest time. Where do sea bats go? I guess that's just a question for the ages. Are there, like, sea trees that they sleep under? Thank you. misses. I think it can miss, but I think it's like one in a million shot. Which is very sad. Yeah, I might as well kill it. Kill freaking Chris when she's trying to get experience.
Yeah, I'm gonna double attack.
I have a feeling. Johnson.